Amadeus the wizard was asleep in his cottage. It was a place where he could study his fireball spell, hidden from the scornful eye of his wife.
Hello, testing, testing.
Turn it off. I'm sleeping here.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
What is it? Who's there?
Once upon a time, there were three valiant heroes chosen by a magical artifact called the Triad. You may have heard another tale of how they met. Let me tell you a story of their latest adventure. Something mysterious and magical was taking place in the forest. First of the three heroes was Amadeus, a wizard. Not perhaps the bravest or the most powerful, but he was clever and sensible. Then there was Pontius the knight, fearless protector of the realm, who loved good food, drink, and battle. Last but not least was Zoya, a thief.
An entrepreneur.
She was mysterious, and only seen as a passing shadow on a cloudy night. Amadeus the wizard was asleep in his cottage. It was a place where he could study his fireball spell, hidden from the scornful eye of his wife.
Turn it off. I'm sleeping here. What is it? Who's there?
This wouldn't stop the great wizard, Amadeus. With his magic, he could lift objects. Amadeus could also conjure boxes out of thin air. light moved through the forest, leading Amadeus further. Torn between fear and wonder, he followed. Needed a counterbalance for Amadeus. This would not be a problem. He could easily conjure a box for that very purpose.
To know what's happening. I try. Not this again.
Yes, get your things. We need to save the kingdom.
What? Oh, this won't do at all, Pontius. I've children waiting for me to come home. I can't leave.
But your magics are needed. The kingdom is in danger.
Will this nightmare ever be over?
Despite his reluctance, Amadeus knew that the heroes were needed once more.
How did you end up here?
Let me tell you.
Pontius had headed out that evening, for there was trouble on the peasant farms. Creeping vines were taking over the fields.
A warlock must be behind this devilry. I'll find him and teach him a lesson with my sword.
Hey,
for dinner tonight.
Pontius searched the farm, but saw no one there.
The nasties must have fled at the sight of me. Dangerous? When I once fought in a battle with dandelions. The trine!
Pontius had never understood what exactly the trine did, but he knew that the artifact was there to help. So Pontius felt happy. He couldn't think of a better quest than saving his kingdom. Late that night, Zoya was concealed in the shadows, hidden from the shimmering moonlight. Through the town as quietly as a whisper. saw a glimmering light moving on top of the old church.
Thievery.
Oh, there's a perfectly good explanation for this. Tell me, where are we going?
We don't really know yet. Something strange is going on.
A new venture. Shall we go then?
So the trine had come for the heroes, and the adventure was ready to begin. Amadeus worried for his family, while Pontius looked forward to their new quest. Zoya, of course, imagined what fabulous treasure they might find.
Begin!
Where are we? What did the trine bring us?
Let's take a look around to find out.
Thank you.
powerful. I'll have to see if it works on potatoes as well.
Thank you. Intruders! Do you think we'll have to fight them?
Get your pocket stick. We cooked the big fat one.
What we're here for, slaying goblins.
A simple, straightforward quest. I like it.
I don't.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My sister is beautiful, charming and bold. I love her so much, we are 8 years old.
Enjoying a shower.
heroes needed to persuade the snail to move out of the way. Pontius suggested tempting it with food. For such a large creature, it must have been at least as hungry as Pontius himself was.
Yeah.
bridge ahead
did not stay up for very long. Zoya looked around at the logs and boxes lying about. Why not try and wedge them under the bridge? Zoya looked around at the logs and boxes lying about. Why not try and wedge them under the bridge?
Thank you.
Coming from those pipes.
Thank you.
bottom of an impassable wall. A piece of the air machine seemed to have fallen off. Perhaps it needed reattaching.
Jolly looking place. And giant snails. Whatever next?
Huge grilled pork, I hope.
Who are these strange people? I better keep my eye on them.
The trine had brought our heroes to a strange forest, where they had encountered goblins and enormous creatures. After facing the perils of the forlorn ruins, they came to a great big steaming swamp. However, they were unaware that someone was now following their journey with great interest.
I wonder what goblins eat.
They eat people, like you.
Oh dear.
Thank you. Ho-ho-ho!
Thank you.
happy little frog.
My sister and I have a secret to hold. I love her so much, we are 8 years old.
I think someone did it.
gigantic nest blocked the path. Surely there was some way forward.
And it shows on my hemline.
Hello?
That flower spoke.
Nonsense. Flowers don't talk.
Can you please help me?
Of course, Lady Flower.
Find my sister on the other side of this swamp. Are we looking for another flower?
Don't worry, Lady Flower. Let's go.
The heroes had found themselves in a magical forest. Pontius had been quite taken by the ladylike flower they had encountered. Amadeus thought the matter with the flower was some kind of an enchanted practical joke. Zoya didn't think this or that about the flower. We'll wait and see, she pondered.
That flower should have told us more.
Easy. We find her sister.
Yes. Let's interrogate all the flowers in the forest.
Smells wrong.
That gas cloud, it reeks of death. Better stay away from it.
sister is gifted with magic divine. Tomorrow we both will be turning 9.
Thank you. Thank you.
or magic water. Maybe we'll get giant strawberries.
I wonder how the water does that.
Is this why the snails and frogs are so big around here?
Thank you. One huge goblin.
You insects, come to me. I crush your bones and make pudding with your flesh.
Let me at him.
Bone Crusher. But how will they deal with the witch?
I hope we can get through safely.
What's this contraption?
Thank you.
Darkness enveloped the marshlands as the night fell. Suddenly, a familiar light flashed, illuminating the country. Where now?
A big tree hat!
More like a tree castle. And the Trine wants us to go in.
The Trine could take us to a nice beach for a change.
Let's go inside.
The torches in the treehouse flickered nervously as the heroes stepped inside. It seemed unlikely that the house belonged to a flower, even a clever talking one. But the warmth indoors was a welcome change after a day in the mire.
This is obviously the home of a witch. They don't like wizards.
A witch, you say?